Thank you, President Ashley, and good morning to everybody who's watching. In partnership with the City of New Orleans and our medical advisors, we continue to track this ever-changing and ongoing COVID-19 pandemic. As many of our officials have said in the last few weeks, this pandemic currently has shifted to impacting mostly the unvaccinated, but continues to pose a threat to our progress forward. Due to this latest surge, we made the decision last week to change our guidance to ensure that all were wearing masks inside of our school facilities, students, staffs, and visitors alike. This was a really important change, and as we continue to evaluate this pandemic, you can anticipate additional changes to the safety measures we put in place. Also, we were very happy to see that the CDC changed their guidance on this topic yesterday, that currently aligns with our current procedures. As Dr. Lewis and President Ashley said, we must preserve in-person learning. It is what is best for our students and what is best for their futures. The best way to continue to combat this pandemic is getting vaccinated for those who are currently eligible and providing ongoing testing for those who are not. We are going to continue to provide ongoing vaccination mobile sites at our schools as we have throughout the summer, and we're going to continue that through the fall semester. We want to make sure that our vaccinations are easy to access, not only for our students, but also for their family members. You can see the schedule of our sites and the dates that we'll be having these mobile vaccinations offered. You can follow us on social media or look at the COVID care section of our website, nolapublicschools.com. We're going to continue working with the public health leaders that we have in the past summer, this summer, to continue those. Ochsner Health Systems, as well as CORE and other partners, will continue to provide those vaccination sites throughout the school year. We urge all eligible students, those who are 12 years of age or older, to get vaccinated. This goes for their parents and their caregivers too. This isn't just about those who are in school day to day, but the entire community coming together to make sure that vaccinations are occurring so we can continue with in-person learning. Our other weapon in continuing to fight this pandemic is ongoing testing, especially for our students who are not yet currently eligible to receive the vaccine. Like the vaccine, we'll be providing access to school-based testing just like we did last fall. So at the start of school in August, CORE will be providing ongoing testing at our school sites that our staff and students can access. And we will continue to have the same resources we had available last year at Children's Hospital and all Ochsner urgent care facilities for students and staff who may need symptomatic testing. What we are incredibly excited to announce is that we are also launching additional testing resources that will be provided to all schools through a partnership with the Louisiana Department of Health, and this will occur in September. With the support of the Louisiana Department of Health, we will have weekly routine surveillance testing for all students and staff in our schools. This plan is being funded by the CDC through the American Rescue Plan, and not only will our schools benefit from the protections a weekly COVID-19 test can provide to our school system, but also there will be financial incentives to every person who receives a test every time they receive a test. Also, our schools participating in this program will also see some financial incentives for their participation. Testing lets us track and contain the spread of COVID-19, and specifically the more contagious Delta variant, and is incredibly important, and we're so excited about having this resource for next school year. Though we will have testing, vaccine is the number one protection available to us, and we need every eligible student, staff member, family member to get vaccinated to continue to allow us to move forward with in-person school for next school year. Everybody, please get vaccinated if you are eligible. Get tested if you've been exposed before starting the next school year. We need your help to continue to preserve in-person learning. And with that, I'd like to introduce the band director of Warren Easton High School, Asia Muhaiman. She would like to share her story with you about vaccinations and how it approaches her work and her school. Thank you.